Hey guys, so this is the third video in this series of freelancing based on my Zoom session. I have added the link to the other two videos in the description box so that you can check later. In freelancer.com, projects are populated based on the skills you choose. Let me explain how you can choose based on what populates on the screen for me now. I will be explaining from a newbie perspective. Okay, for this project, the employer has good ratings and he also has favorable pricing. But I am a newbie and applying to this is not going to benefit me as he has clearly mentioned that he needs a professional person. This is a fake project. Whenever you see such projects about seeking models or video call is included, you can skip it. Next, these kind of jobs with no detailed information. We cannot be sure if they are genuine or fake, so my advice would be to go for it if you have more number of bids. But if you have lesser number of bids, avoid bidding on these projects and go for projects which are applicable to you and where the employer has good ratings. Here, this person is looking for a company, so as an individual freelancer, you might not be preferred. You can go for projects like this, working on Instagram. Even though this employer does not have reviews, he has mentioned his expectation in detail, so I would definitely write a proposal and apply for this project. He has also mentioned that you should sign a non-disclosure agreement, so if you are okay with it, you can just proceed. Here you can also see that he has made a deposit to freelancer.com, which means you might not be cheated. Project wise, this person is also looking for a professional, so it might not be suitable for newbies. To explain proposals, I will consider this project. Here the employer has reviews, he has deposited to freelancer.com and the price expectation is high. However, he has mentioned that he is going to pay only $2 per 500 words. So the price expectation mentioned above here becomes void. That is about 0.28 INR per word. I hear from my content writing friends that the range is about 0.2 to 0.5 INR for beginners. So, if you are okay with this price, you can go ahead and bid. The bid section should have value more than $10, even if it is void, because freelancer.com won't accept a value less than the employer's mentioned expectation. I have shown on the screen how I would write the proposal for this project as a newbie. The employer has mentioned to begin the response with "I agree to your terms and rates," which I have done. After that, I am explaining to the employer that I am a newbie with no experience and hence won't have samples. But I am also confirming that I can do a sample work for him before he hires me. Below the proposal, you would see optional upgrades which I do not recommend. The employer's decision is final and I don't think these can help much. Next is milestone payments.
This, if he is doing a fixed project of $100, and you can just split that 100 into milestones. And I show you a sample work. So you pay me 5, and I complete the work, then you're going to pay me another 10. So it should total up to your final bid. Nowadays, you're able to see what other people are bidding. So this is just for your reference.
I have also added the link to my winning bid in the description box. If you want to see another proposal sample, please check the blog link.
Like, how do you know that the employer is genuine or
yeah, so we will never know. And unless we try and work for them, we'll not know if they are genuine. So my suggestion would be, you can always tell them that you will work for them for 1 week and you can get the payment for per week basis. So that even if the employer is not genuine, you will know after 1 week instead of working for a month and then getting your payments. So that's what I have been doing.
Okay.
How is payment made to freelancer or how it is done? Okay. So when you go through a project and when they pay, it will go here. Your dashboard will show how much you have earned. You might have earned 70 USD. Then you will just have to give your bank details and they will transfer it to you. But they have some limits. I think you have to earn at least 10,000 to withdraw your money. So when you're doing small, small projects and when it comes to your account, you will not be able to withdraw it.
So you said the minimum amount to withdraw is 10,000. So in that 10,000, how much would be the pay cut for freelancer?
It will be 10%.
That time itself, they are going to take the pay cut, or it is only after it touches
when
10,000?
It credits into your account balance itself, they will minus their commission and only credit it. So whatever you see on your dashboard will be the amount after commissions.
Correct.
As you go, you will be able to understand which is genuine, which is not. If it is a captcha job, then you can feel free to neglect such projects. If it is a project where they are asking you to pay some amount, then reject it. If they are going to go and ask you to come on a video call, you can reject it. Yeah, I think that's all. Okay. You can always Google and check if some related jobs are there. So Google will probably tell you if it is genuine or not. Or you can read it on Quora. I think you are aware of Quora, right?
Yeah.
So you can check on Quora and people will be telling you whether it's genuine or not. So do your groundwork and then you can bid for projects. And apart from freelancer.com, there are many Facebook groups who offer jobs. So I think you can connect to these Facebook groups. One is called Headhunters. They have genuine job requirements and you can just comment on them and contact them via messages and let them know you're interested. I'll send in the group also to you in WhatsApp. Some people do cold contacting. Like they will just, you can just ping Instagram small businesses and tell that I'm ready to work and if you have anything, just let me know.
But does it really work, Akash? Because I don't know
if it will work, but this Facebook groups will work. Like join in multiple groups, not only the one I'm going to tell you. There are multiple groups that say you can find jobs. Again, the same applies to these Facebook groups also. Some might be genuine employers, some might not be. But only thing, you don't have to pay for a free trial or something like that. It might give you the probability, right?
I get it.
Have some other friend who's doing a business, you can check with them if they have a requirement. That'd be the easiest way to connect and get at least some knowledge about business and sales. I prefer sales. I mean, everybody is selling something or the other, so there's more possibility in sales.
Thank you. I'm done with my questions.
Thank you.